We are getting excited here at Hawkeye News as we are starting to line up visits to our area elementary schools in the coming months to talk to our elementary viewers about leadership and what it takes to be a part of the Hawkeye News team. Teachers, please send your email requests to Chief Lindsay and keep a close eye on announcements at www.hawkeye-news.com for more information. Now to catch us up on what's going on at our elementary and intermediate schools, we go to our elementary intermediate school reporter, Jennifer Terry, to see what's happening. Jennifer?
Thanks, Katie and Brandon. We have a full plate of news from our elementary and intermediate schools, including our first report from our intermediate school writer, Ellen Stanfield. So let's get started with this month's elementary intermediate report. Apples, apples, apples. Apples are everywhere in kindergarten at Red Oak Elementary. During the month of September, the students were busy learning about Johnny Appleseed, and they learned many apple facts. One of the favorite parts for the students was a chance to eat apples, and they even had a chance to make applesauce. The students learned that apples are a healthy treat and very good for making strong bodies. Thanks to Mrs. Alamo for submitting this story. In September, Red Oak Elementary School hosted its first family movie night in the school's cafeteria to enjoy family time with school friends and a movie free of charge. The next family movie night will be December 8th from 5:30 to 7 p.m. with the movie Polar Express beginning at 7 p.m. The Techno Jungle was made possible through the Red Oak Education Foundation. The room itself is decorated like a jungle with a treehouse loft and rock stairs. The walls are painted with trees, vines, animals, and a waterfall. The goal of the room is to provide teachers with a means of teaching to read through technology. In the room, there are computers, Leapsters, V-Smile games, Between the Lines DVDs, and Leapfrog games. There is also a smart board in the room for teachers to use for instruction. The students are motivated to read because they are surrounded by unique, fun, and educational reading games. Our goal is to support our struggling readers and second language learners through a variety of hands-on activities while enriching, challenging, and encouraging our gifted and talented kids to achieve. Thursday, September 28th was a wonderful day for Wooden Elementary students as author Debbie Leland visited all the classes and told them what it was like to be an author. Mrs. Leland also went on to read her world-famous book, The Jalapeno Man, and brought to life several of her characters of the book using Wooden Elementary students. Mrs. Leland graduated from Texas A&M University with a degree in physical education. She taught elementary school for 22 years in College Station, Texas. In 2001, became the librarian at an elementary school. Mrs. Leland is a mother of two. Her book was on sale the day of the event, and students of all ages had a wonderful time. Shields Elementary, like others from around our district, had a great time in early September as many grandparents of Shields students came to have lunch with them in honor of Grandparents' Day. The students would like to say thanks to their grandparents who took the time to enjoy lunch with them on this special day. Shields also recently held their open house. Parents were invited to visit with their child's teachers, and Shields PTA offered pizza so families could enjoy dinner together. Students at Shields Elementary experienced a touch of the Wild West on Wednesday, September 27th. Julian Franklin, education storyteller, taught Texas history and information about the library use and reading. Students joined Mrs. Franklin's bunny, David Hopperfield, as he zoomed in a time machine back to 1845, the year Texas became a state. Shields students and staff appreciate Shields PTA sponsoring this exciting educational journey. Mr. Mike Jacobs recently visited Red Oak Intermediate School. Mr. Jacobs was born in 1925 in a small Polish town of Konin, a town whose Jewish community dated back to 1397. On September 1st, 1939, Poland was invaded by the Nazi army. 2 months later, Mike and his entire family were herded into cattle cars and moved to the ghetto. His parents, two brothers, and two sisters were murdered in a Nazi death camp. He is the founder and past president of the Holocaust Survivors in Dallas. The students who heard Mr. Jacobs learned very valuable lessons, lessons that are important to us all. We are also very excited to bring you this report by our new Hawkeye News writer, Ellen Stanfield. The drama teacher, Mrs. Archer, has started a drama club. The tryouts were held on September 20th and 21st. 100 talented students tried out, but Mrs. Archer was only able to keep 30 in her club. The meetings are on Thursday afternoons from 3:10 to 4 p.m., during which time they do many things. They will be designing short PA announcements for Red Ribbon Week and creating character skits to perform to the fifth graders. Best of luck to you, future actors of America. Ellen also wrote a great story about their wonderful principal at Red Oak Intermediate, Mr. Major. In an interview by Ellen, she found out these interesting characteristics about the man in charge of ROI. Mr. Major worked as an assistant principal for Eastridge in 1995. He was a temporary principal for Wooden Elementary in 1997, and the year after that he returned to Eastridge as principal. Before that, Mr. Major taught social studies, reading, English, and GT. His first teaching job was teaching ISS. Mr. Major likes to spend time with his family and enjoys camping, computers, and building furniture. That does it for a very busy month for the Elementary and Intermediate Report. I'm Jennifer Terry. Back to you guys in the studio.